unsuspected connections. In many society, including many parts of India, the line of descent and inheritance passes from father to son. This is understood at a patrilineal system. Keeping in mind that women tend not to get properly right, the government of India in aftermath of Kargil war decided that financial compensation for death of the Indian soldiers should go to their widows so that they were provided for. The government had recently not anticipated the unintended consequences of these decisions. It led to many forced marriages of the widows with their brother-in-laws. In some cases, the brother-in-laws was the younger child and sister-in-laws a younger woman. This was to that the compensation remained with the decent man's patrilineal family. Can you think of other such unintended consequence of a social action or a state measure? This emphasizes on scientific procedures can be understood only if we go back in time and understand the context of social situation within the sociological perspective emerged as sociology was greatly influenced by the great development in modern science. Let's have a very brief look at what intellectual ideas went into the making of sociology. Now we learn how sociology is formed. Sociology bani kis tarah? It is on page number 9.6, the intellectual ideas that went into the making of sociology. Influenced by scientific theories of natural evolution and findings about pre-modern society made by early travelers, colonial administrator, sociologist and social anthropologist sought to categorize societies into types and to distinguish stages in social development. Anthropologist is the person who studies human society and culture and their development. So, sociology ko banaya kisne hai? Travelers ne, colonial administrators ne, sociologists ne, and social anthropologists ne. And what they did, they categorized the society into its types. ताकि ये देख सके कि किस तरह की development आ रही है society में, social development किस तरह की हो रही है. These features reappear in 19th century in works of early sociologist Auguste Comte, Karl Marx and Herbert Spencer. Efforts were there made to classify different types of societies on what basis. For instance, types of pre-modern societies such as hunters and gatherers, pastorals and agrarians, agrarians and non-industrial civilizations. तो पहले society को, pre-modern society को कैसे categorize किया गया था? First थे hunters, second gatherers, third pastorals. Pastorals means people who keep sheep for grazing and gatherers, like shepherd kind of people, and agrarian. Agrarian means people who belong to agriculture only. And third was agrarian and non-industrialized civilizations. Second point says that types of modern societies such as the industrialized societies. So, modernized societies kine kaha jata tha? Jahan industries thi, jahan par industrialized societies thi. So, pre-modern societies wo thi jahan par agrarian society reh rahi thi. Hunters, gatherers, pastorals reh rahe thi. And modern societies wo thi jahan industrialization thi. Such an evolutionary vision assumed that the West was necessarily the most advanced and civilized. Non-Western societies were often seen as barbaric and less developed. तो ये कहा जाता था कि जो West countries हैं वो ज़्यादा advanced हैं, ज़्यादा developed हैं. And जो countries non-West societies में आती हैं, वो क्या है? Barbaric हैं. Barbaric means uncivilized हैं और less developed हैं. The Indian colonial experience has to be seen in this light. Indian society reflects this tension which go far to the history of British colonialism and the intellectual and ideological response to it. Since 2004, perhaps because this backdrop, Indian sociology has been particularly thoughtful and reflective of this practice. You will be engaging with Indian sociology, though its concern and practice in greater detail in the book. Understanding Sociology NCERT 2006. तो जो इंडियन सोसाइटी है उसे बोला जाता है बारबरिक. बारबरिक मीन्स अनसिविलाइज्ड, लेस डेवलप्ड. क्यों? क्योंकि वो वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज़ की लाइट में अभी नहीं आई है. इंडियन सोसाइटी रिफ्लेक्ट्स दिस टेंशन. और इंडियन सोसाइटी को, इंडियन सोशोलॉजी को यही टेंशन है दैट इंडिया अभी उतना डेवलप्ड नहीं हुआ है जितनी वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज़ हैं. Darwin's idea about organic evolution were a dominant influence on early sociological thoughts. Society was often compared with living organisms, and effort were made to trace its growth through stages of comparable to those of organic life. This way of looking at society as a system of parts, each part playing a given function, influenced the study of social institutions like the family of the school and structures such as stratification. We mention this here because the intellectual ideas that went into making of sociology have a direct bearing on how sociology study empirical reality. So here what we are learning? Different ideas of the sociology. So what Darwin idea says that our society is working according to the different segments which are working for each another. Here we'll take an example of a body. Our tissues are responding to the cells and cells are responding to the body. If tissues will not respond to the cells, and so as body will not work. So as in the society, for society, social institutions are working, and social institutions are working ahead for the development of the whole society. Agar social institutions ko respond nahi karegi, to hamari jo sociology hai, hamari jo well-being hai, welfare hai, wo nahi hoga. हमारे जो इंटेलेक्चुअल आइडियाज़ हैं वो क्या फ्रेम करते हैं? एम्पिरिकल रियलिटी. एम्पिरिकल रियलिटी मींस साइंटिफिक स्टडी. हमारे जो आइडियाज़ हैं वो क्यों आते हैं? क्योंकि हमारा कोई ऐसा साइंटिफिक एक्सपीरियंस रहा है, तभी हमें आइडियाज़ आते हैं. हमने कुछ ऐसा देखा है, एक्सपीरियंस किया है, तभी हम एम्पिरिकल रियलिटी के थ्रू हमारी सोशियोलॉजी में स्टडीज़ करते हैं. The Enlightenment and European intellectual movement of the late 17th and 18th centuries emphasized reason and individualism. There was also a great advancement of scientific knowledge and a growing conviction that the methods of the natural sciences could be extended to the study of human affairs. So 17th and 18th century mein, late 17th century mein, ek movement hua tha that is known as European intellectual movement. And isme kis cheez mein emphasize kiya gaya tha, kis cheez mein focus kiya gaya tha? Reasoning ka. Log puchne lag gaye the, why you are saying this thing? Reason. Question mark aa gaya tha. Aur individualism aa gaya tha. Individualism means har person apne liye kaam karne lag gaya tha. Pehle log ikatthe milke kaam karte the, but after this revolution, after this movement, sab apne liye kaam karne lage. प्रॉफिटिज्म में आ गए, खुद के लिए प्रॉफिट अर्न करने लग गए. सेकंड, नेचुरल साइंसेज में डेवलपमेंट आ गई थी. साइंटिफिक नॉलेज ग्रो कर गई थी. लोग एक्सपेरिमेंट्स करने लगे थे क्योंकि उनके पास अब रीज़न था. रीज़न का उन्हें आंसर मिलने लग गया. आगे वो अपनी स्टडीज़ को और फॉर्मुलेट करने लग गए. तो हियर इज़ एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स. Poverty, far seen as a natural phenomenon, began to be seen as a social problem. So, poverty पहले क्या सोचा रहता था? एक natural issue है. उस person के कारण, वो जो particular person जो गरीब है, वो उसकी गलती है कि वो गरीब है. पहले ये माना जाता था. But जब हमारी development आ गई, तो हम क्या समझने लगे उसे? एक social problem, society की problem. Caused by human ignorance or exploitation. और वो क्यों हुआ है गरीब? या तो किसी ने उसको इग्नोर किया है, उसकी कैपेबिलिटीज़ को ध्यान नहीं दिया है, उसके कैलिबर को रिकगनाइज नहीं किया है, या उसको एक्सप्लॉइट किया है, तंग किया है. पॉवर्टी देयरफॉर कुड बी स्टडीड एंड रीएड्रेस्ड. वन वे ऑफ स्टडिंग दिस वॉज through the social survey that was based on the belief that human phenomena can be classified and measured. You will be discussing social survey in chapter 5. Thinkers of the early modern era were convinced that progresses in knowledge promised the solution to all social ills. For example, Auguste Comte, the French scholar, considered to be the founder of sociology, believed that sociology would contribute to the welfare of humanity. क्योंकि हमारे पास अब रीजनिंग की पावर आ गई थी, अब हमारी जो मॉडर्न साइंस थी वो भी डेवलप हो गई थी, वी आर हैविंग नॉलेज एज वेल. तो वो नॉलेज ने हमें क्या किया? नॉलेज ने हमें प्रॉमिस किया, हमें सॉल्यूशंस दिए जो भी हमारी सोशल प्रॉब्लम्स हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल, अगस्ते कॉमटे, हु इज़ नोन एज द फाउंडर ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, हु इज़ द फाउंडर ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी? अगस्ते कॉमटे और कॉमटे, ही इज़ द फ्रेंच स्कॉलर. अब इन्होंने ये बताया है दैट सोशियोलॉजी वुड कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू द वेलफेयर ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटी. सोशियोलॉजी की वजह से ह्यूमन वेलफेयर होगा. किस तरह होगा? क्योंकि हमें जब किसी चीज़ की प्रॉब्लम पता चल जाएगी, हम उसके सोल्यूशन ढूंढेंगे. अब उस सोल्यूशन से क्या होगा? वेलफेयर होगा.